A is for astronauts.
I wanted to become an astronaut since I was a little kid.
Wanted to be an astronaut since I was six.
As a child, I wanted to be an astronaut.
You all have one commonality.
The fulfillment of a lifelong dream.
Since I was a little kid, being an astronaut is all I ever wanted to do.
Get to realize our childhood dreams.
Started saying I wanted to be an astronaut when I was 5 years old.
I interviewed four times over 12 years.
I applied multiple times over 13 years and interviewed five times before I was selected.
Well, I did submit seven applications along the way.
Got rejected by NASA seven times, but the eighth time.
Do you want to go to space? Maybe you want to know exactly what it takes to be an astronaut. Fact is, practically anybody can become an astronaut. Everyone wants to make sure you're healthy enough to do it. But that's about it.
Space is for everyone.
Everyone has a special talent that they can bring to our astronaut corps.
Be hard work, perseverance, doing the right thing, showing up on time, and showing out.
Contribute to our space program simply by being yourselves.
Let them know you're in that room and you're there because you belong there.
Puts 100% effort into everything he does.
In awe of the curiosity she displays.
Awesome teammates and a really great friend.
Selection and screening of individuals is critical.
I went through 6 months long interviews and tests, psychological tests, cognitive tests.
So how do you get really good people? Well, you shell a lot of peanuts till you get one that's really good, and then you put that in the basket.
The first thing I want you to understand about how a narcotic detector dog is trained is it is very simple to train a narcotic detector dog.
The hard part is finding the right dog to train.
We could look at possibly 100 dogs and maybe one out of the 100 qualifies for a narcotics detector dog. We look for a dog that has an incredible ball drive. All of you have seen this dog. Everybody hates this type of dog because when you go to the backyard, they jump up on you, they tear things up, and they want to chase their ball over and over, and they're just psycho about their ball.
That's the type of dog we want to start with.
Is it the future? Is it the key to reaching the stars?
Or is it just five totally awesome days away from mom and dad?
I used to work for a man named Warner Von Braun, who was the founder of America's space program and certainly the father of the moon landing. And he believed that the youth of America was
a very valuable resource.
And his concern was that we must prepare for the next generation of space travel. And to do that, we must have a bright, challenging young group of people coming up to meet the requirements of our next effort.
At some point in the future, we'll look back and say, how did we do it without space?
I am absolutely convinced the emphasis here on space is absolutely vital to our
new world order. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order.
We must have a bright, challenging young group of people.
It will be many years yet before our plans can fully materialize.
We're going to look back and say, how did we do it without space?
And basically, since we're in microgravity environment, you can learn about the human physiology by the lack of gravity. We can figure out about when we go to further to Moon or Mars. And also, because we understand better about human physiology, we use that knowledge to help our everyday life on Earth.
Don Pettit, the man who can't say COVID, no matter how hard he tries. Doink!
How do you hit something and knock it straight down in space? It's a bug. Look.
Doink!
He's like actually just slow, man, I think.
Oh, it's because he's so smart, Big Bear. He's so smart that he sounds retarded. And you're like, that isn't how that works. He doesn't seem at all competent to even wipe his own ass.
You can see the zodiacal lie.
Whoa. Zodiacal lie?
Whoa.
Yeah. Look at this guy. It's like you're being trolled, man. That he could fully believe he's up there for all I'm concerned. Right? That's maybe why some of the astronauts aren't always the smartest.
You know, these are super smart people.
People who see you in your blue flight suit may not know you by name, but they know who you are. They know who you are because you are NASA.
I am a transgender woman. I am NASA.
Are you thinking about being an astronaut someday?
No. Yes, thank you for your honesty.
But I'm not going to be an astronaut.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
Seen a launch, Junction Jack. One time? Was it really something?
Count down with us, everybody.
10.
9.
8.
7.
6.
5.
4.
3.
2.
And the, gosh, what's the next number?
Number 1.
Oh, yeah. 1.
Ignition.
And blast
off!
I hope your eyes are filled with stars, because today we're gonna go to space!
Oh my god! Look at it!
You need a lot of strong energy to go to space!
Oh my god! It's so big!
Are you ready to have some fun? Here we have our super space crew. Don't they look so cool?
Now look, one of the astronauts has left the spacecraft.
Isn't that neat?
Mama thinks it's really cool.
Just look at his shiny silver spacesuit with his supersonic jetpack. That's so cool. Wow, awesome. Well, like I always say, two astronauts are better than one.